Why do we play games? Researchers around the world have spent decades measuring the effects games have on our society, how they influence violence, addiction, and laziness, but we rarely ask why we play games in the first place. Psychologists and sociologists are only now beginning to understand why the human ability to play is so powerful, but they have come to understand that games actually fulfill several psychological human needs. In their book, Glued to Games, How Video Games Draw Us In and Hold Us Spellbound, Richard M. Ryan and Scott Rigby talk about these psychological needs and how games target them. The first of these needs is a need for competence. This is the drive to seek out control or feel mastery over a situation. People love to feel successful. We like to feel like we're growing in our knowledge and accomplishments. Think about all the times you've seen a successful business person switch careers or go back to school because their current job was no longer rewarding. They might not know how to express it, but they're looking for that need to feel competent. It's easy to see how games make us feel more accomplished. Every time we level up in an RPG or defeat a challenging boss in Dark Souls, games tickle that desire to feel competent. Another psychological need is the need for autonomy. This is the desire to feel independent or to have a certain amount of control over our actions. This drive towards autonomy is why people instinctively dislike being manipulated. It's why imprisonment is a punishment, and it's why we find slavery disgusting. Games are virtually defined by their ability to give us choice. Every time we explore one of Grand Theft Auto's open worlds, or navigate one of Mass Effect's dialogue trees, or leave a main quest to hunt for secrets in Breath of the Wild, we satisfy our need for autonomy. We love games for a lot of reasons, but one of the most powerful is how they tap into our need for relatedness. This is the third psychological need. We like to feel like we matter to others. We like to feel like we are making a significant contribution to society. In fact, in a 2003 study, the University of Massachusetts Medical School discovered that people with altruistic tendencies, people who go out of their way to help and interact with others, these people generally had a higher level of mental health and less overall stress. It's easy to see how games fulfill this need for relatedness when friends gather online to play Fortnite or Call of Duty. But oddly enough, this need for relatedness is also satisfied when we interact with people who aren't even real. That's why a lot of game quests are structured around helping an NPC find an item or save a loved one. We want to matter to other people, even fictional people. Over the centuries, we've gravitated towards experiences that make us more competent, more autonomous, and more related because these experiences make us feel good. They improve our mental health. These needs can be fulfilled in a number of ways through work, school, friends, and hobbies. But video games might be one of the most seductive of all of these activities because they meet our psychological needs more effectively than most any other activity. The world isn't fair. Sometimes our coworkers praise us for knocking it out of the park, but really we just phoned it in. Other times we burn the midnight oil and no one seems to notice. Video games are powerful because we know what to expect. Games tell us exactly how much work we need to put in to reach the next level. They tell us exactly how many side quests we need to complete to clear out an area. Games are more consistent at rewarding us for the choices we make, and they provide a diversity of choice that the real world lacks. Games are immediately rewarding. They provide instant feedback when we do something right, and they tell us how well we perform every step of the way. Can this lead to unhealthy practices? Sure. Games are really good at satisfying our psychological needs, which is why we love them. It's why we want to keep playing them. It's why we get lost exploring these digital spaces for hours, only to emerge suddenly, realizing we're hungry, tired, and late for work. Video games are a poor substitute for many of life's other needs, but they provide a psychological good. I believe that video games hold the potential to show us the world through a different set of lenses, to craft experiences that engage our mind both cognitively and socially. And ultimately, they make us feel like an active participant in shaping our destiny. That is why we play games.